I know that someday I will be free. Ask myself, in spite of the pain, how can they do it again and again? My sister, she was taken away before I never saw her face, 'cause I could never turn around, but I listened to her.
After 2 to 4 weeks, the exhausted sow is separated from her piglets, typically 8 to 12 babies in any given pregnancy, never to see them again. She is then re-impregnated and returned to the gestation crate, a process which is repeated for 6 to 8 litters, after which she too is sent for slaughter. Her precious piglets, upon separation, are placed in dark sheds, in absolutely sordid, jammed pens, and will remain there until sent to the slaughterhouse, unless they are female, in which case their fate may be much like their mother's.
And then there are the horrifying conditions of the pigs, which are extremely clean animals, by the way, scientifically proven. But these intelligent, sensitive beings are locked in crates so small they can't even turn around all their miserable life. But the worst is their actual death process. You see, oh God, I have to tell you, but it's heart-wrenching. First, the pigs are stunned, often unsuccessfully, leaving them still conscious when they are hung by the feet and cut open with a knife. In fact, they are still alive when they are next put into a vat of boiling water, with videos that have shown them still twisting in pain. Imagine if it's us. Imagine if it's our loved ones. Imagine if it is human. All this for a piece of meat, dead flesh that often causes even more diseases to humans. Not like it even helps us in any way. Is it really worth it? Tell me. Please.
No.
Is it worth it?
No.
It's not. It's not. You're right. How can we degrade ourselves into such an inhumane, heartless state of being by supporting these cruel, heart-wrenching practices? I ask myself. How can we justify causing that much suffering to another being when the alternative is so easy, affordable, and at hand, and healthy?
Supreme Master Ching Hai loves this song and has a message for the artist, an association member from New Zealand, who wrote the music and lyrics as well as performed the vocals. Wow, thanks for being a real love. All animals deserve freedom and the right to live the way nature intended. The Buddha benevolently said, "All beings tremble before violence. All fear death. All love life. See yourself in others. Then whom can you hurt? What harm can you do?" On this anniversary that celebrates the life and teachings of Lord Buddha, let us remind ourselves of his wisdom and indeed honor the spirit of Vesak every day by protecting animals and following an organic vegan diet, thus creating heaven for all. For more information on Vegetarians International Voice for Animals, or VIVA, please visit www.viva.org.uk. Thank you for joining us on today's program. Coming up next is enlightening entertainment after noteworthy news. May a vegan planet soon be ours.
For more details, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/stop-animal-cruelty.